Hello everyone. Today we're gonna make a hand saw, another simple object for enhance your modeling skill in Rhino. To make this model, you need to download a bitmap that I've prepared for you in a link on description below. On the first our pop-up menu, we're gonna select a template. A centimeter. And from the top view, we're gonna place our bitmap. From the middle here, turn on your grid snap and try to make it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 60 centimeter long. So in the grayscale here, we're gonna make it not a grayscale, so the PNG image leaving just a line that will be our clear guide. Just click enter or right click, so we can begin to making our model here. But first I want to separate these models into several parts. For the first, and I want to arrange them in different layers. So we start with lines and curves, so we can store our tracing lines and curves there. And the second layer, I'm gonna put a metal plate there, and then handle a basic handle there, and rubber handle there, and the last one will be our bolts. We're gonna start with making metal plate for our handsaw. So start with making point. Turn off grid snap again so we can easily follow that lines that becoming our guide. You don't have to be worried. Your tracing line or your object being not that precise. Turn on your grid snap again so your last line will be placed in the middle of the red axis. I want to turn off that again. I want to extend that curve, this curve there. So I want to extend the curve by line for our first line and the second line, and this line. And please and press enter. Select them all and cutting the excess trim the excess curves that you don't need. Get with the 2-point circle press hold your shift key, just copy this and drag it to the right. I want this to be adjusted so I can make our two-point rectangle, so we can trim in a curve that we don't need and join them together. Alright, I'm gonna make this again. Trim that. And I think I'm gonna leave that for the teeth so we can make our teeth for the plate. Them together again and found the intersection of between, I don't think so, just this a little more, and we can trim that, and we can delete that. And we array this, we're gonna try 53. There you go. I think it's just 52. No, 50. That's good. Okay, gonna join them together and trim this, the last one, trim this, that first line, and join them again. Now we have that we need. We're gonna extrude this 0.7 millimeter. Because this model in this centimeter template, I'm gonna make this 0.07 centimeter. That means model will be 0.7 centimeter thick. Let me choose those lines and I want to make a new sub layer below lines and curve, so it's gonna be a metal plate or metal plate, and I wanna put our lines, our first line there, and turn it off. To make a sharp teeth, we need to remember that saw teeth having a crisscross sub teeth, so one in the top and one in the bottom. So we're gonna make, we're gonna chamfer edge this on the top and this on the bottom, this on the top and this on the bottom. See the result. As you can see, the result is not solid, it's leaving a hole there. So we're gonna export that. Still, so we having those leaving open. I'm gonna make this nice. Let's open it. And we're gonna this. Okay. See then. This is weird. So now we have okay. So we're gonna array this again. 50, 51, 1. Turn off this intersection. So let's see. That's that's awesome. So now we have. Teeth template. I'm gonna cut this plate with the teeth that we recently made. So hold Control Shift S and select the teeth that we recently made. Okay, that's cool. Let's see. And now, as you can see here, we can trim this. Select them all together and join them. Okay, let's check this either and open edges or naked edges. Oh, that's sweet. Okay, now we have our metal plate and we can make our next part, which is its handle, in our next video. If you successfully learned something from this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share it. And check my other video. If you have any question, just let me know in the comment. See you.